Welcome back. We're here for round one of the scholarship tournament, where these somewhat talented golfers are attempting to raise scholarship funds for NCCA member schools. The ocean course is very difficult, or at least appears to be very difficult from the looks of this golf. We're also joined again by our other sideline reporter, Darla Todd. Hey, Darla.
Hey, Erica. Yes, I'm back out here today against my better judgment.
What happened to your combat gear?
No need for it today. I've decided to stay out behind the golfers where it's safe.
Sounds good. Let's check out some of today's action.
First off is Pro-Am co-chair David Miller. I'm a little afraid that Dr. Miller is going to break something.
He could, but it certainly won't be par.
Of course, you can't mention Dr. Miller without talking about Dr. Scott True. The last person that complimented his swing was Stevie Wonder.
Here's Cliff Hawks. His wife Edna told me that Cliff's instructor recently told him to take 2 weeks off from the game, then quit. Steve Dahl from Chick-fil-A, I think he would be better off playing his divot. It went further.
And here's Lancaster, Pennsylvania's own Rob Hess. His golf balls are like eggs. White, sold by the dozen, and a week later, he'll need to buy more.
Also from Pennsylvania, it's Omar Fisher. Omar has the distinct honor of being the only amateur in 30 years to lose 2 golf balls in 1 ball washer.
That's mean. They should really lower those ball washers. Kyle Nedestad is from Chicago. He's best known for his hard work ethic and flashy clothes.
Goodness, just imagine if he didn't practice.
Loosey goosey.
There's the founder of the NCCA Pro-Am, John Wheeler. After 4 rounds on the ocean course, he'll need to re-grip that ball retriever.
Man, Scott Pothoven's swing creates more trouble than Donald Trump's Twitter account.
The pressure of the video got to me.
I think Dan Wood's fake eye could see the line better than Rob McCloskey.
Jim Ward might find Jimmy Hoffa in those woods.
And hopefully a golf swing.
Hang in there, David Wheeler. One day you will shoot your age.
Maybe when you're about 112.
Well, round one is in the books, and I believe that Darla and I have shown you ladies exactly what you're not missing. Thanks, everyone, and enjoy the rest of your Pro-Am.